Malnutrition has changed in the past 50 years. Although people eat more food than their ancestors, millions still suffer from vitamin and mineral deficiencies that cause serious health problems and sometimes death. Purdue University plant geneticist Torbert Rocheford is part of a team that is naturally fortifying corn with pro-vitamin A as a way to improve nutrition around the world.
Globally, you have 250,000 to 500,000 people approximately are going blind each year from vitamin A deficiency. And the sooner, and in parts of the world where this is occurring, maize is a major crop. In sub-Saharan Africa, there's a cultural preference for white corn. They eat white corn, it's nice and clean. Yellow corn is for animals and is avoided. They don't eat it. And orange corn, they really haven't seen much of. Some of the carotenoids are called provitamin A carotenoids, and they make vitamin A when the body consumes them. They're essential vitamin. White corn has almost no provitamin A carotenoids, just a minimal amount in the embryo, but none in the endosperm. Yellow corn has some carotenoids, but it tends to be very low in provitamin A carotenoids. Orange corn is a type of corn where we have been breeding for high levels of carotenoids. Just like you have orange carrots, they have a lot of beta carotene, which is a carotenoid. This corn involves natural variation. It comes from inbreds developed by plant breeding. And some of these inbreds were developed 30 years ago, before GMOs were even out there. And so this is just a natural process. This does not involve transgenics or GMOs.
Well, what is biofortification? And it's using plant breeding to put more minerals and vitamins in staple food crops. It's a very inexpensive and sustainable way to provide more minerals and vitamins in poor people's diets.
We really need a multidisciplinary and interdisciplinary interinstitutional effort. It's not only CIMMYT and the breeding part, but it's actually many other disciplines that have to be involved. So Harvest Plus is working really hard on ground, trying to deliver all these research products that we are producing and trying to deploy all these new varieties to the consumers.
The team includes researchers from Harvest Plus, Cornell and Michigan State Universities, and the International Wheat and Maize Improvement Center, also known as CIMMYT. The project involves three stages. First, researchers study which genes boost provitamin A levels in corn and then use that information to develop varieties that can grow in African soil. The second step is to test whether eating orange corn improves consumers' vitamin A levels. Finally, Harvest Plus helps farmers in Africa adopt the varieties and educates the African public on orange corn's nutritional benefits.
You'd have to get in some educational and promotional activities to actually get the people to adopt something that's different. So right now we have promotional activities going on with the Harvest Plus team. They're working very hard trying to educate the consumers about the importance of provitamin A maize. And the results so far have been very promising.
But the story I like to tell is that they were having a field day in Zambia for the farmers, and the country Harvest Plus country manager, Harvest Plus is involved with the biofortification program, he brought some ground orange corn for them to make shima for the event, and he came a few days later, and all the plates were white shima except one for the dignitaries and politicians. And so he went and asked the cooks, "What happened? I brought enough shima for 100 people. There's 70 people here, and you only have one plate." He says, "Oh, we heard this corn has vitamins, so we took it home and fed it to our children."